I'm Patrick Ronoh from Kenya. I just completed my MSc in sanitation. Before coming to IHE Delft, I used to be a research assistant with a research and consulting organization dedicated to improving health in the global south. Some of the sanitation issues we face in Kenya is access to improved sanitation. This is a major issue, especially in low-income settlements in urban areas. We find that in recent years, there's been rapid urbanization as people migrate into cities, and most of these people end up settling in low-income settlements. So we find that the city authorities are not able to cope with this influx of people, and are therefore struggling to provide basic services like sanitation. Another thing we find that in areas that have sanitation facilities, they're usually inadequate, and most of them are not able to safely contain and dispose of the excreta, which now leads to environmental contamination and eventually outbreak of enteric diseases. So the three things I learned from the third part of my study is one, sanitation technologies, especially for non-sewered sanitation. The second thing is emergency sanitation, where I got a deep understanding on sanitation in a humanitarian context. And lastly, behavior change and advocacy, where I got to learn more on behavior theories and advocacy methods, which are from leading experts in sanitation, and how they designed and implemented successful interventions in developing countries. This research was on exploring seasonal variation in fecal risk pathways in a low-income settlement in Kampala using a Sanipath. So Sanipath was developed to characterize risks from fecal contamination in low-income urban environments and to identify the most dominant fecal exposure pathways so as to help prioritize sanitation investments. So the aim of my study was basically to identify the most dominant exposure pathway and to make a comparison between seasons. So what I found out is that street food and open drinks were the most dominant pathways in both seasons. And the surprising thing that I found out is that the risk from these particular pathways was highest in the dry season. Living in Delft was exciting. I really enjoyed the serene environment and also the friendly people. Also got to make lots of friends from all over the world, and where we got to share some of our experiences and also got to learn from them. The cycling culture is something that I really admired most in the Netherlands as a whole. Overall, I really enjoyed my stay in Delft. So I'm planning to pursue a PhD in the near future. Before that, I'm planning to go back to Kenya. We still have a lot to do in terms of sanitation if we are to achieve the SDGs. I believe the skills that I've acquired at IHE Delft will come in handy.